All right, guys. So now I want to talk about the NFC East, formerly known as the NFC Least. But that's no longer the case. I think the NFC East has a pretty good argument to be one of the better divisions in the entire NFL. Three of their teams made the playoffs last year. One of their teams went to the Super Bowl. And that same team that went to the Super Bowl is considered by many people to be the most stacked roster in the entire NFL. So I'm going to talk about the NFC East and how I think it's going to play out. So obviously, the elephant in the room, the giant elephant, the elephant that probably didn't get a DUI is the Philadelphia Eagles. And the Philadelphia Eagles are, in my opinion, I've said this before, I think they're the best team in the entire NFL. The Eagles, they have a great quarterback. They have two really good receivers. They have a great offensive line. They have a really good tight end. They have a really, really good defensive line. The linebackers kind of suck, but who gives a fuck about linebackers, you know what I mean? And their defensive backs are pretty good as well. I think they got a little bit weaker in the defensive backfield. I think those corners are a little bit older. Losing C.J. Gardner-Johnson definitely sucks. If you're going to have a white man getting significant time at DB, it's probably not a good thing. But nevertheless, the Eagles are just insanely stacked. The biggest problem for the Eagles right now, though, is that they lost two of their coordinators. They lost Shane Steichen and they lost Jonathan Gannon. Jonathan Gannon, in my opinion, wasn't that big of a loss, but Shane Steichen, I do think, is a pretty big loss for the Eagles. I think he was one of the main people responsible, outside of Jalen Hurts himself, for the revival of Jalen Hurts' career, for the acceleration that he showed, both in the passing game and just as an NFL quarterback in general. So I think that's a big loss, Shane Steichen, but to me, that doesn't make the Eagles a whole lot worse. I still think that they are going to be in contention for the NFC's number one seed. And honestly, with how weak the NFC is, wouldn't surprise me if they win it outright. Their schedule is definitely significantly tougher this year. And you know, that's how the league is supposed to work. You're supposed to get a tougher schedule when you were good. And when you were bad last year, you get an easier schedule. So, you know, reality is often disappointing, unfortunately, for the Eagles fans. They can have a cakewalk schedule every year. That's not me calling them frauds. I'm saying that, you know, their schedule is definitely tougher. Their schedule is definitely a lot tougher. And will that prevent them from maybe being the number one seed in the NFC? I could see it happening. But in my opinion, they're still the best team, if that makes sense, right? But we all know the higher seed isn't always the best team. And I think that might be a case with the Eagles. I think their floor, you know, as long as Jalen Hurts is healthy, I think their floor is like the number two seed. And that's a pretty damn good floor to have if you're the Eagles. And again, would I be surprised if they're in New Orleans in February playing against one of the AFC's best teams for the Super Bowl? I wouldn't be. In fact, I'll do my predictions in a later video, but possibly when I make my predictions for the year, I might have the Eagles hoisting the Lombardi Trophy, something they haven't done since 2017 with Nick Foles. So who knows? But enough about the Eagles. You guys know how good they are. You guys know how many additions they added this year in the draft. Jalen Carter, Kelee Ringo, Nolan Smith. They also added DeAndre Swift. I mean, their team is just, they're the Georgia Eagles, the Philadelphia Bulldogs, whatever you want to say. They're a pretty good team. They are a pretty damn good team. I don't necessarily need to talk about the Eagles. You guys know where they're at. It goes without saying, I think the Eagles are going to be the number one seed in the NFC East. I think they're going to win the division again. And I have the Eagles going 13-4 once again this year. So I think that they're going to be a clear-cut top team in the NFC. The Dallas Cowboys are another very interesting team. The Dallas Cowboys are a team that, how do I say this nicely? And I have to be careful because my girlfriend's mom is a Cowboys fan. I have to be very careful. The Cowboys are always a team that people overrate the shit out of. Everybody overrates the shit out of the Cowboys. They talk about Dak being top five and Mike McCarthy being a top 10 coach and da-da-da-da-da-da. Stop. I wouldn't consider myself a Cowboy hater. I would consider myself a Cowboy realist. And what I mean by that is I'm able to look at the Cowboys and say, yes, this is a pretty talented team. Dak is a good quarterback. CeeDee Lamb is one of the league's best receivers. Their offensive line, you know, if they could stay healthy, is pretty good. I really like Tony Pollard at running back. He's my fantasy running back last year. Really like Tony Pollard at running back. And obviously that defense is awesome. You know, Micah Parsons, Trayvon Diggs. They added Stephon Gilmore, who I think is a pretty good get as well. And then Dan Quinn. Y'all know Dan Quinn's my guy. He was the defense coordinator for the Seahawks during the Legion of Boom days. Y'all know that, right? So when I look at the Cowboys, I'm like, okay, this is a talented team. This is probably a playoff team. Unfortunately, though, I think one of the things that's going to hold the Cowboys back, well, there's a few things that I think are going to hold the Cowboys back. The first one being Mike McCarthy. Mike McCarthy has never been and will never be an impressive coach in my eyes. I think Mike McCarthy is, he's realistically, he's like an NPC, right? He doesn't move me in any way. When the Cowboys moved on from Jason Garrett to hire Mike McCarthy, I was very confused because it felt very much like a lateral move. You're not getting better or worse with Mike McCarthy. I don't think he necessarily makes the Cowboys good. And when you get into those upper echelon of teams, you need a guy that's really going to win you some games, right? There are coaches in this league that win their team's games almost single-handedly. And obviously they have players, but they're able to elevate their team to a degree that they wouldn't be able to reach with an average or below average coach. And I think that's the rut that the Cowboys are in right now with Mike McCarthy. He's good enough to not get fired, but he's never going to be good enough to win them a Super Bowl, which is obviously something that the Cowboys haven't done since the VHS days. So maybe they're not even remembering what a Super Bowl is. They just think that life exists to go to the divisional round and then lose to the 49ers. But alas, I will stop myself from more Cowboy roasting. Here's the thing. The Cowboys are a team that I think whenever they have this current core in place with these guys and with Dan Quinn as defensive coordinator, they are a playoff team. You know, barring another season-ending injury from Dak Prescott, I really don't see a scenario where the Cowboys just miss the playoffs outright. You cannot tell me that the Cowboys are not a top seven team in the NFC, staying relatively healthy, right? So I do think they'll make the playoffs. I don't think they're in the same league in terms of talent, coaching, quarterback play as the Philadelphia Eagles. Obviously, I don't have them winning the East, but I think the Cowboys are going to be the number two seed. I have them going 10-7, making a wild card game at least, maybe even winning, but I don't really see them getting past the divisional round, unfortunately. I don't think that you're a serious contender with Dak Prescott and Mike McCarthy back there. And as much as I was nice to Dak Prescott a few minutes ago, he's very clearly not in a top five, top seven-ish range. He's kind of that second tier where it's like, okay, he's good, but he's not like Super Bowl good, if that makes sense. All right, so Cowboys, I have them going 10-7. I have them at least making the playoffs. And there's that. So moving on to number three, the New York Giants. And we want to talk about people that are absolutely overrated. I think Daniel Jones has become one of the most overrated players in the entire NFL. Now, up until last year, at this point in his career, he had been a bust as a number six overall pick. He had been injury prone. He'd been inaccurate. He'd been everything, right? Everything except for short, because the guy's 6'5", right? So Brian Daboll coming into the Giants, he turned that team around right away. I mean, the Giants, they were a completely different team with him as coach versus Joe Judge as coach, right? Brian Daboll, I think, is a great coach. I think that he is probably the best coach in the entire division. I would put him above Nick Sirianni personally. I think he's one of the better coaches in the entire division. Problem is that I think the Giants, they're probably the third or fourth most talented team in their division. Like I said, I don't love Danny Dimes, and you just gave him that big contract in the offseason, 30-something million. I think it's $36 million a year, if I'm not mistaken. To me, that's a big mistake. Saquon Barkley, there's still issues going on with his contract. Don't know exactly what's going on there. But outside of that, I mean, your receiving room isn't great. I like Jalen Hyatt out of Tennessee, but, you know, he's a third-rounder rookie. Darren Waller at tight end, I think, is past his prime, unfortunately. And your defense is kind of middle of the pack. So nothing to me really sticks out about the Giants other than Brian Daboll. And again, coaching can only get you so far, I fear. Bill Belichick is one of the greatest coaches ever, and they've been nothing without Tom Brady. So coaching, I think, can only get you so far in this league. And I think Daniel Jones is gonna go back to the public perception of him from over a year ago, where he was considered to be a waste of a sixth overall pick for the Giants. Now, you know, New York, they did go to the playoffs last year. They did win in the playoffs last year against the Minnesota Vikings, who I think is another fraudulent team. But, you know, well, I think I already talked about that. But they did beat the Vikings in the playoffs, so they did more than the Cowboys, as they actually, you know, the Cowboys won a playoff game as well. They won against Brady, and then the Giants won. Giants went on to play the Eagles, and the Eagles, they blew them off out of the fucking stadium. I mean, there was no, that game was over in like the first three plays. I mean, the disparity between the Eagles and the Giants was just so evident there. Additionally, for the Giants' defense, I totally forgot to mention, they did lose Julian Love to the Seattle Seahawks, and I thought that was one of their better defensive players. So that's a big loss, I think, for New York. But it's just evident to me that the Giants are just so many tiers below the Eagles. And I don't know, I just talked a lot of shit about the Cowboys, but to their credit, they gave the Eagles two good games. And obviously, I know Jalen Hurts, you know, wasn't participating in one of those games, but Gardner Minshew is not a bad backup quarterback, and the rest of the Eagles were still pretty healthy. And the Cowboys really, I mean, they were scoring on that Eagles defense, and that Eagles defense was good all year. So I digress. But the Giants, they weren't even in the same league as the Eagles. The Eagles just blew them out of the stadium. I think that there's going to be a little bit of regression in New York this year. I don't think Daniel Jones plays to the level that he was last year. I think, you know, maybe the offense takes a step back. And I don't know. I don't know what I think about the Giants. I think that they probably go 8-9. Unfortunately, I don't think that they make the playoffs this year. I think there's too many other talented teams in the NFC, namely teams like, you know, Detroit and Chicago. Not Chicago. Seattle. So, you know, I don't know. Can I see them sneaking into the seventh spot? Yeah, but I don't see them being a real contender, unfortunately, this year. And then, you know, last place, we have Washington. I'm just going to say it all right. I think Washington is really bad. I like the receiving room. I think Curtis Samuel, Terry McLaurin, and Jahan Dotson are pretty good. But I don't like much else other than that. Their defensive line is good, yes, but Chase Young might not be a Commander next year. I mean, I don't really know what's going on with that, you know. So we'll have to see, you know, everything going on there. But I kind of have them going 5-12. I don't love Ron Rivera. I love him as a human being. Don't love him as a coach too much. So we'll just kind of have to play by ear and see with the Commanders. But to me, they're easily the least talented. They probably have the worst coach. They probably are the worst at quarterback. And when you have a lot of those things, it's really not a great recipe for success in the division. So, yeah, that is my NFC East preview. Let me know what you guys think down below. And let's go ahead and get to the next segment.